What factors cause an increase in PSA levels? If you are over 50 and starting to worry about your prostate health, you will have heard of the PSA test. The PSA test is one of the initial means of testing for prostate cancer. PSA stands for Prostate-Specific Antigen. It is a protein produced by prostate cells. It is quite normal to have a small amount of PSA in your blood. But as you get older, the amount rises and your prostate gets bigger. A raised PSA is not always a medical concern, but may suggest a problem with your prostate. However, a number of factors can contribute to a rise in PSA, and there has been much debate as to the reliability of the PSA test. You see, a PSA test is unable to distinguish between different causes of a rise in PSA. Prostate cancer, benign prostatic hyperplasia, BPH, and prostatitis can all cause a rise in PSA. Therefore, while there is no doubt that spreading awareness of prostate cancer is important, the results of a PSA test can lead to an unnecessary biopsy, which can cause pain, bleeding, and infection. In some cases, it can even lead to overtreatment. So, let us review some of the factors that can increase PSA that aren't prostate cancer. 1. Aging. Age is one factor that we simply have no control over. Older men's normal PSA levels run a little higher than those of younger men. Normal levels also tend to vary a little between different ethnic groups. Your doctor will evaluate your test results, factor in your age, ethnicity, and any other relevant factors, and let you know whether your results suggest more testing. 2. Enlarged prostate. BPH is not prostate cancer. It simply means that your prostate gland is larger than usual. In this case, there are more cells in the prostate gland, and there are more cells that produce PSA. The condition itself is non-cancerous and usually affects men over 50. 3. Prostatitis. Prostatitis is an inflammation of the prostate gland. Unlike cancer and enlarged prostate, it is often caused by common strains of bacteria. As microbes enter the urethra, they can travel upwards and spread to the prostate if left untreated. An inflamed prostate caused by bacteria can be treated with antibiotics. Once they are killed, the inflammation usually subsides and your prostate gland eventually heals. However, prostatitis can be long-term and recurring. In this case, it might take more time and effort to treat it. 4. Urinary infections. Urinary tract infections are less common in men. However, if you have a urinary tract infection, PSA levels can be skewed. Thus, it is sometimes recommended to run a urine test along with the PSA test to rule out infections. Similar to prostatitis, a urinary tract infection causes inflammation and makes the prostate release more PSA to the blood. 5. Sexual activity. PSA levels are increased after ejaculation. The effect usually goes away after 24 hours and it is minimal. Still, it is recommended to abstain from sex 24 hours before a PSA test. 6. Pressure upon the prostate gland. Any type of pressure upon the prostate gland may increase serum PSA levels. For example, riding a bike for a long time or having a digital prostate examination could result in a small spike. The PSA test is a valuable tool for early detection of problems in the prostate. However, the test itself cannot be used to determine the presence or absence of prostate cancer. A drawback of PSA screening for prostate cancer is that it can often lead to overdiagnosis and overtreatment of non-aggressive cancers. So, while a PSA test is useful, it needs to be viewed as simply a tool to obtain more definite information. When having a PSA test, get all the information you can and speak with your doctor before getting a biopsy. There are alternatives to a prostate biopsy, like MRI and the PSA3 test. These methods are non-invasive and accurate. What are your experiences with PSA testing? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. If you've learned something new from today's video, make sure to subscribe to Ben's Natural Health YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Also, if you want more tips on the best natural ways to manage your enlarged prostate, head over to bensnaturalhealth.com.